thank you all so much for coming to join us tonight to give our big welcome to the Moscow Class Center for Musical and Dramatic Arts. As I'm sure you have heard, since you're here, Theater 308, 32 of us have been spending about a month or so with members of the Class Center. We've just gotten back from Moscow and Leningrad, where we performed Man of La Mancha, to the most wonderful, receptive, encouraging audiences we've ever met. And tonight we are excited and proud and, well, really thrilled, I think, to welcome the Class Center here to our stage. And I wanted to thank all those of you who have also welcomed these students and their chaperones into your homes and been doing all the transportation and so on that's been going on all week. Let me see. The director of the Class Center is Sergei Kazarnovsky, and he asked me to say a word or two tonight before we begin, because he has some concerns about the fact that most of the play is in Russian, although there is a little bit in English. I don't think it's going to be a problem, but he's asked me to say a word or two about the show itself, so I'd like to do that. I hope that by now most of you have read the synopsis of the play in your program. And in reading it, you will probably find that it's sort of maybe not the most coherent statement that you've ever read. And that's because it was, obviously it's a translation. Language barriers, we've been having a wonderful time, but they are real, and sometimes we take a little, takes a little negotiating to try to figure out exactly what's going on. And unfortunately, we had to have all that at the printer before I had the chance to watch the show a couple of times and really get a feel for what was going to go on. But the story that you read in the program really is the text, the basic storyline, but it doesn't talk about the subtext, about the allegorical level of this piece. And so I just want to take a minute to talk to you a little bit about that, because that's really what's the most important. Allegory, I'm sure you know, is fabled stories about life and about the human condition. And perhaps in this case, more specifically about life in the Soviet Union for the past 70 years. So there's a little political twist as well. The central idea, Sergei tells me, is that of overcoming the barriers that arise or that are present between different types of people, and overcoming them in order to try to find a mutual language, a mutual understanding, a way to for people to work together, live together, sing together, prosper together. So each of the animals that you read about in the story represents some different type of human being. I'll give you a couple of examples and then I'll leave the rest up to you to figure out. For example, the first character that we meet, I believe, is the rooster. And this rooster might represent perhaps a political figure or a hypocritical leader who demands a certain way of life from his constituency and says, work, 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 you must go out there and do what's best for the masses, but perhaps himself does not follow his own best advice and lives a different kind of life. We see this rooster inspiring all the other roosters to get off to work, but he himself stays at home and hangs around with the hens. We also see some crows who are representative perhaps of those kind of people who mindlessly follow the old ways or follow directions without thinking about what they're doing, without thinking about the future and the way things may turn out. There's a fox, for example, who must learn to become wily and cunning in order to survive. A family of goats, simple people, and so on and so on. And I'll let you watch for the other characters. The main character that I do need to mention, of course, is the wolf. And the wolf, I believe, is all of us. The wolf has to overcome his own inner struggle and learn to balance the two sides of his nature, the one side which is pursuing more lofty human ideals, perhaps. He's a lover of music, he's a lover of dance. He has high ideals, but he also has to eat, and he's a wolf, and so he has to kill to do that. And this is a problem for the wolf, and that's his, pardon me, his inner struggle. Finally, I think the message here is one of hope. I think you'll see this. It's one of hope, and it's also one of great joy and great excitement. It's one that suggests that through song, through dance, through communications of all kinds, through laughter, through theater, we can all learn to work together and live together and prosper. And what better way to begin that communication than right here tonight by welcoming the Class Center to our stage. Thank you so much. Enjoy the show.
Of the dark forest and instructs them through his song of the work to be done. The fox, awakened by the rooster, wants to feed the rooster to his family. Now, just watch, friends.
Ya-du-du-ka-ka Thank you. shit is all up.
Loves music very much and dreams of the muse at night. However, in the morning, his hunger makes him forget his music and only be concerned about eating. The morning may finish off badly for the goat kids if the crow patrol doesn't come in time to save the day.
Thank you.
ноги за травы.
Доми нет, ни крошки так протянешь ножки. А ко мне охота топать на охоту. Мама коза идет на базар, а дома одни там будут когда-то.
Будем мы послушны, слово дали маме. Ах, как дома скучно, за семью замками. Как это нам сэмбре и немножко пьета. Впрочем, наша песенка до конца не спета.
Yeah. Rhinos.
все, что такие медвежьи, будут встречаться все реже.
And then, suddenly, a giraffe appears in the path of the wolf.
Bye.
Next, the thorny rogue beats the wolf to a tranquil rabbit field.
High spirits, he twirls his tail, but it doesn't mean that he will be put in good mood if somebody twirls his tail. Thank you.
обильный сесть. Вилка слева, ножик справа, рядом соус и приправа. Что хотите, говорите, но сначала накормите. Я к музыке не глух, но мой слабеет слух. Все вам петь про палки, елки, а вокруг голодные волки, волчий голод. Thank you.
very time there's a great feast at the fox's house, at which the fox and her kids are devouring a delicious rooster, the gold demigod.
Yes. Thank you. Ha ha ha! нации лозу. Как однако вкусно петь умеют козы. Доказать смогу я на примере личном. Даже волчья может быть лично гармонично.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I want to say great thank you for everybody who helped us do it performance. The first, Nancy Herrmann. Thank you. Her kids. Theta 318. And all parents, all families, of course, thank you.